Now, restoration of the structural integrity of units 1, 5 and 9 staircases at the Nalubale powerhouse have been completed. The project had cured cracks first identified as early as 1964 due to alkali silica reaction, which causes a structural movement of civil hydro infrastructure in the presence of water. According to Eskom Uganda Limited Managing Director Ntozama Ganji, nearly a billion Uganda shillings was invested in the restoration of the powerhouse.
Eskom staff first toured completed works of the project and later addressed the press at their headquarters at Nalubale Power Station in Jinja. Managing Director says refurbishment of units 1 and 5 plus 9 staircases was undertaken by Babcom Uganda Limited, a Ugandan-based company, to improve their structure integrity and ease accessibility to the lower gallery of the PowerPoint.
So we have brought in Babcom to come and work on the staircases, which is one of the series of projects that we are embarking on to deal with the alkali silica reaction in Nalubale. So they have worked on the staircases, they've repaired them, and hence we're commissioning them this afternoon, which is a milestone that we are really excited about, as you have seen that there was also some work that was happening in the upper gallery, also on the cracks, and we showed you what we think it would look like after completing those cracks.
Ganji said the project was of important significance to the lifespan of Nalubale Power Station because it is the first of many a number of projects that Eskom is currently undertaking to address a historical challenge of the alkali silica reaction, which has troubled civil hydro infrastructure worldwide.
The powerhouse of Nalubale has that challenge of alkali silica reaction. And part of ensuring that, some scholars call it as the cancer of the concrete. It is not curable, but you can mitigate and try to manage the cracks as they develop over time.
Nalubale Powerhouse, constructed in 1954, consists of three levels: a machine floor, upper and lower galleries connected through concrete stairwells. While handing over the project to Eskom, Godfrey Zuriwende, a managing director of Babcom Uganda Limited, said it was a delicate job that required precision in fabrication and installation of equipment, as well as identifying and sealing leakages in the concrete.
This job was not easy, but as engineers, we manage processes and systems, and with the help of Eskom engineers, we came up with a solution and have successfully gone through the project. And now, at least for now, the problem seems to be mitigated.
Formerly known as Owen Falls Dam, construction of Nalubale Dam commenced in 1950 at the source of the Nile in Jinja. It was commissioned on April 29, 1954, by Her Majesty the Queen of England. Eskom Uganda Limited is the biggest hydroelectricity generation company in Uganda. Regulated by Electricity Regulatory Authority, Eskom currently produces on average 138 milliwatts per day. Report by Donald Kia for the news, Jinja.